problem is to write a Python program to display the multiplication table. Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. My name is Ayushi Jain. In this video, we will learn how to write a Python program to display a multiplication table. So guys, from our childhood, or let's say since our childhood, we have been struggling learning these multiplication tables. What if we can write a program in Python that will allow us to display or any multiplication table of any given number? So let's have a look on how it can be done. In Python, it can be done with the two solutions. First solution is using for loop. Second solution is with using while loop. First of all, we will be talking about the solution number one, that is our for loop. Let's have a look on how it can be done. So multiplication table using for loop. Now first, let's understand the logic of a table. First of all, let's write a table over here that 7 multiplied by 1 is equals to 7. 7 multiplied by 2 is equals to 14. 7 multiplied by 3 is equals to 21. And so on, it goes on up to 7 multiplied by 10, that is equals to 70, right? Now what we need to do, we need to put this formula inside our for loop. How for loop will work? First of all, let's take a variable from the user, that number is equals to input. And let's say the user gives us a number 10, okay? Now what we need to do, we need to use a for loop over here, that for I in range. The range will start from number 1 because we will be taking 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 10 numbers over here. This 7 is going to remain constant. That means this number 10 is going to remain constant. But here this range, this I is this range 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 10 over here. And how it will go up to 10 over here, we will be writing 11 over here. Because why we are writing 11, let's remove this and put it as 7 so that you don't get confused over here between 10 and 11 over here. So why we are taking 11 over here? Because we need to iterate up to number 10. So if we want to iterate up to number 10, we need to write one number addition to the existing number. So we will be writing 11 over here. So for I in range 1 to 11, what we need to print a simple formula that for 7, we will be writing our number, that whatever our number is, comma. For the multiplication operator, what we will be doing, we will not be actually multiplying it. We will just be displaying it. That's why we'll be writing inside the string that we'll write x, comma, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This will be kept inside the range, that is our I. So we'll be writing I. Again, is equals to over here is not an operator. What we'll be doing, we'll be just showing it over here to display it inside our table. Is equals to, comma, lastly, number multiply by I. So here actual multiplication will happen. So we'll be writing number, that means number is 7 and I is, let's say 1. So number multiply by 1 will give us the first value, then number multiply by 2 will give us the second value, 3, 4, and it will go up to number 10 over here. So number multiply by I. In this way, we will obtain a table over here. And let's put this formula, let's put this method inside our PyCharm and let's see what happens. So solution 1 using for loop, first of all, let's take an input from the user that number is equals to int input, enter a number here. After this, what we need to do, we need to use a for loop that for I in range, we'll be taking the range starting from 1 goes up to 11, we'll put a colon and what we will print over here number, comma, we'll be actually showing that multiplication operator over here so we can write x and multiplied by I. Again, is equal to needs to be shown only. And now actual multiplication will happen between number and I. So now let's run and see what output we will get. If I run this, we are getting the output as enter a number here. Let's say I want to know the number of. So I'll put a number 7 over here. And as you can see, I have received a table over here in our output screen. 7 times 1 is 7, 7 times 2 is 14. And similarly, up to 7 times 10 is 70 over here. This is how we have obtained the table. In this similar method, what we can do, we can find the table of any other number. So if I run it and write 8 over here, then I'll get the table of 18 over here. So how interesting it is that within a line of 3 code, it has solved our childhood problem of learning all these tables. Now let's talk about our solution number 2 over here. Let's see what is our solution number 2. So in our solution number 2, we will be using our while loop. For while loop, simple concept is there that while loop iterates till the condition is true. Whatever condition you have given till that condition is true, while loop will keep iterating. So here we will take two variables. First of all, number. Number is equals to, again, we can take the input from the user over here. So I'll just copy paste this one over here. And I'll be taking another variable, let's say A over here, that A is equals to initially 1. Okay, this A will keep the count of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now what we will be doing that while A is smaller than equal to 10, in that condition, what we will print? We will print the same formula that we have used before. So I'll be writing number, comma, x, x is for the cross, times, this time we will be writing a over here because our a is holding all the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and we'll be writing a, again comma, is equal to symbol, again comma, and number times a. Lastly, what we need to do, we need to make an increment over here that every time this a will increase by 1. So right now it is 1, after one iteration it will increase by 1, then it will become 2, then 3, then 4, then 5 and up to 10, and after 10 it will stop because what condition we have given, we have said that while a is smaller than or equal to 10, only till that time we have to iterate. So we'll be writing a is equals to a plus 1, or you can also write a plus is equals to 1, totally choice is up to you. So let me remove this previous code, I'll put it inside the comment and let's run this one. So if I run it and write any number over here, let's say 12. So I'll obtain the multiplication table of 12, that 12 times 1 is 12, 12 times 2 is 24, and similarly 12 times 10 is 120 over here. So I hope guys that both the methods are clear to you. Firstly, we use the for loop. Secondly, we have used the while loop, and both our programs are ready, which will do the same task only. So whichever program you think that is more easy, you can write it down in the comment box as well. So I hope you guys have no doubts and no questions, and for more such interesting programs, stay connected guys. Thank you.